I'm Pam Henry, and I started to work at WKY-TV in June of 1972. I was the first woman hired there. I'd been a reporter at KTOK Radio, and one day at City Council, I went over to Lynn Sassenrath, a reporter for Channel 4, and I said, I hear there's a reporter opening at Channel 4. Do you think I should apply? And he said, Channel 4 will never hire a woman. And I thought, great, 4 years of college in broadcasting and journalism, and Channel 4 will never hire a woman. But I went in to apply anyway, and Jack Ogle had been recently named the news director, so he was doing the hiring. He's the father of all the Ogles you see in Oklahoma City television here in 2012. He said, and later denied that he said, but he said, we've been looking for a woman. Stations all over the country were starting to hire women. And since I had a news background in Oklahoma City, no TV experience at all except for film classes and TV classes in college, I got the job. I was so excited. Everyone was a reporter photographer, and we were all issued our own silent cameras. We didn't all have sound cameras, but every person in the newsroom had a silent camera that was with us 24 hours a day. When I went in to interview with Jack, he said, do you know how to shoot film? Oh, yes, sir, I do. Well, I had taken film classes at OU under Ned Hockman, who's the best, but I had my final project shot for me by a friend who worked at Channel 5 television. So me saying I knew how to shoot film was a little bit of a stretch, but in that day and age, women had to stretch. I also have walked on crutches all my life from polio, and I tell handicapped groups that in 1972, it was more of a handicap to be a woman than to be walking on crutches. But I did get the job. Eventually, I worked up to the point that I could apply for the midnight news. That was a 5-minute newscast that came on at midnight. And after I did that for a few months, I got to do the 7:25 and 8:25 cut-ins in the Today Show. And sometimes I did both. I'd be there at midnight, come back in for the 7:25. When Brad Edwards came to our station from Texas, he was also assigned to the 7:25, and he said, you're not using any film in your cut-in. And I said, well, we never have. And he said, with all this time you have? So we started using film in the 7:25. After I had done the 7:25 and 8:25 in the morning cut-ins for a while, Russell Pearson went to either Ernie or Norman Bagwell, the general manager, and said he would like to have some news in the farm show. So the person who did the 7:25 then became the news person on the farm show at about 6:20 in the morning. So we went in really early. And Ken Root was the assistant farm director. Well, I was the only person in the newsroom at 6:20 in the morning. It was very quiet. I turned on the lights, but other than that, there was no one around. Ken Root would come down from the farm department offices and sneak up behind me and go boo, and I would jump a mile, and I can't tell you how many times that happened. I went out to do the news on the farm show the first morning, and Russell Pearson said, here's our own Miss America, Pam Henry. I said, thank you, Russell. There were 3 rapes and 5 murders in the state of Oklahoma last night. Didn't sound much like Miss America. I've been told in years since that because I was the first woman hired to work in Channel 4, there was quite a bit of discussion about it. And one time, everyone in the newsroom got together to talk about, did they really want a girl, to come to work at WKY-TV. And they knew that I had been in to apply, so they figured it was probably that Pam Henry from KTOK Radio. Fortunately, most of the reporters and photographers were my friends by now because I had seen them at stories that we all covered. Bob Dodson, who of course won an Emmy for Through the Looking Glass Darkly and is now at NBC, said, I've seen her at fires And even though she's on those crutches, she jumps over fire hoses. I think she'd be great. And other people chirped in that they thought I would be a good addition to the newsroom. While I was at WKY-TV, live local news became the big thing. We changed from film to minicams and videotape, which allowed us to do live shots. Oliver Murray was the best live shot producer anywhere. And so we would do live shots. But it was hard to get the microwave signal from the truck back to the station. And quite a bit, quite often, you could not get the live shot established. So by the time I was the weekend anchor, there was a murder in Oklahoma City. And my crew, God love them, they were gung-ho. They said, we'll go get you a live shot for your 10 o'clock newscast. And I thought, oh, wonderful. That signal may or may not get back. I may or may not have a 3-minute story on a murder in my 10 o'clock newscast. I was petrified. The crew went out, and the murder had been down in a very low part of Oklahoma City. And try as they might, it was impossible to get the live signal from the WKY-TV truck back to the station. So they called in and they said, Pam, we're sorry, we can't do the live shot. And I went, whew, now I can just go do my straight newscast. Not very aggressive, but at least the newscast got on and off on time. We timed our own newscast. We did not have producers. We did not have teleprompters. So getting off on time was very important. Robbie Robertson was my sportscaster. I was his news person. And I had a habit of reading all of my news, no matter how much time it took. Well, that meant that I hit weather late, and weather took all of his time. And so Saturday night after Saturday night, we were hitting sports late, and there was no place to go. He had to cut some stories from his show. Well, Saturday in Oklahoma, especially in the fall, sports is extremely important. You've got OU and OSU football and all the other football teams. So Robbie and I had a little powwow, as Jack Ogle used to say one day, and he said, Pam, you've got to get off on time. I'm getting gypped every single newscast. So I learned how to do a better job of timing my newscast and dropping the stories I needed to drop. When all of the news video was on film, it was news film, you had to put the film all together in one reel, and that reel had to be in order. Because you took it up to projection, it would roll with the first story, it would roll with the second story. So getting the news film up was extremely important. And different people took charge of getting it done every night for the 6 and noon, 6 and 10 o'clock news. Well, one evening, we were late. We were very late. Eddie Gaylord, the grandson of EK, the son of EL, was an intern, and we called him Fast Eddie because he was the fastest runner of anyone in the newsroom. And he would run the film up. But even with Fast Eddie taking the film up to projection, we got it there way late. That left Jack Ogle out on the news set reading news stories and reading intros to film, and there was no film there. So he'd skip the next film story and go to his what we call a reader, just a straight on the camera words only story. During the commercial break, they finally got the news film up there. And we all waited in the newsroom until the end of the newscast, because we knew how much problem and how much embarrassment we had caused Jack Ogle by not getting the film up on time. We were a little afraid, actually, I was, for Jack to come back in the newsroom. He walked in, and of course he had this booming broadcaster's voice, and he just looked around the newsroom at all of us, and of course we were going, eh. And he said, the newscast starts at 6. That's all he ever said, and that was all that needed to be said. We were never late again. We were a family at WKY-TV, and we were so proud to work there. Of the top 10 television programs, including entertainment, movies, situation comedies, everything, 7 of the top 10 programs in Oklahoma City were WKY-TV newscasts. I remember one time in those days, the weather radar was a television screen set in the base of the podium where the news people stood. So while one camera shot the meteorologist who was over there, the camera that usually handled the news person was to shoot the radar. We were getting ready to do a 7:25 cut-in. They said 15 seconds, and at that exact second, the radar, which was a small television screen, blew up. Glass spattered out, smoke went up. I thought it was going to catch on fire. I was sitting on a stool. My crutches were across the studio. I didn't know what to do. Larry Brown, the meteorologist, ran down from weather, picked me up under my arms and set me down across the studio where it was safe. And then he ran back up, and I wasn't there to do the news, so he did the weather first. During the commercial break, we got me back. We cleared the smoke away, and I went ahead and did the news. WKY-TV was a pioneer in broadcast news. At the very heart of it, it was news. It was journalism. We could not do a story. We could not go out the door unless we had two sides to each issue lined up ahead of time. And I so appreciated that. A lot of that came from Ernie and also from Jack. But that was an absolute. We always had to have both sides, same day, same time. It was an honor to work at WKY Television. The people who were there when I was there, the people who followed us and are still doing a fabulous job, I'm so proud that that's on my resume. When I would go out of town, out of state, people knew the reputation of WKY Television. And I'm so glad I got to see so many people. When I fell off a horse at one point and broke my leg and my hip, because I'm not supposed to ride horses, I got a tremendous amount of mail. And a lot of it was from the farm show audience. But people felt like they knew us, and we just loved reporting the news to the betterment of Oklahoma.